Uncle Vernon's first meeting with my dad went badly. Being a proud owner of a Volkswagen electric car, Uncle Vernon asked my dad what car he drove. My dad tried to be funny and he said that he drove a racing broom. Uncle Vernon refused to talk to my dad since then. He thinks dad is some kind of amateur magician who does tricks on the street. Mrs. Weasley once sent me an invitation by Muggle Post for the Quidditch World Cup. The letter was covered in stamps, except for a small area where the address was written. Uncle Vernon turned beet red at the sight of the letter and wanted to give me a proper spanking for not teaching Mrs. Weasley common sense. Uncle Vernon saw me as nothing more than a waste of space. He wants nothing more than to squash the magic out of me, and I was forbidden to use words like magic, broomsticks, Hogwarts, or wand in the house. I've been living in the cupboard under the stairs since I came to live with my aunt and uncle. It was full of spiders, but I'm not afraid of them. I was quite happy to have a personal space. Uncle Vernon somehow got the idea in his head that others in the magical world would find out how poorly I was treated, and so he gave me Dudley's spare bedroom. It's like an upgrade to a first-class ticket. I have a desk, a chair, bed, cupboard for my belongings, and a place for Hedwig's cage. But it's a different ballgame when it comes to food provision. Aunt Petunia controls everything that goes in and out of the kitchen. Aunt Petunia's cooking is not exactly amazing, but as a constantly hungry teenage boy, anything goes. Aunt Petunia placed my cousin on a diet when she received a letter saying that Dudley was too overweight. Obviously, for moral support, the whole family had to follow his diet of eating nothing but grapefruit for dinner. Well, the joke's on her. When I found out about the outrageous diet plan, I SOS'd Ron and Hermione, who sent me a bunch of wizarding goodies to munch on. No sweets for Dudley. He's on a diet, remember? Everything was going well until Dobby visited me. Dobby is a house elf bound to the Malfoy family until I freed him. Dobby suffered unemployment after he was freed. Other house elves treated him with hostility and he was shamed for being out of work. Although Dobby was ecstatic to be free from his abusive masters, he did enjoy working but wanted to be compensated fairly. He landed a job at the Hogwarts kitchen and was paid 4 galleons per month and received one day off each month. Honestly, I think that's peanuts. But as long as Dobby's happy, who am I to judge? Maybe I can score some treats from Dobby from the kitchen out of hours? I'm craving for a bowl of spicy fish balls. That's on a special menu, I think.